In this video, we will show you how to set visibility on certain rows and how to filter data by genre. Our design builds on the sample discussed in the previous tutorial. We will create a combo box that will enable us to switch between the genres. Let's first delete the space control we added in our first tutorial. The next step is to insert a static table right below the top label. We will need two columns and one row. Drag the label control to the first cell and type select genre. Then drag the combo box control to the second cell. The next step is to create an attribute in the persistent tree. The attribute will be called genre. Then set the default value to all. We will explain this value a bit later. The genre attribute will be used to store temporary user selections from the combo box. By default, persistent data is retained on the client device after the solution is exited. When the solution is opened the next time on that client, the persistent data will be displayed. The genre the user selects will be stored in the genre attribute and displayed in the combo box. To associate the genre selection with the combo box, drag the genre attribute from the tree to the combo box. The next step is to decide what values will be displayed in the combo box. Double-click the combo box to edit it. In the Edit Combo Box dialog, you can supply static values or use XPath. We are going to use XPath. If new genres are added in the future, our XPath expression will take care of them automatically. Now let's start building our XPath expression. Double-click the genre node in the data source. This way, we tell the expression to pull all the genre values from our data source. Run the simulation to see how this affects the display. As you can see, we've got quite a lot of duplicates. Let's go back to our XPath expression and fix it. To have a sequence of values with all the duplicates removed, we will use the desyncValues function. Start typing this function and then you can use autocomplete. Run the simulation again to see the changes. Now you can see that we've got all the relevant genres and all the duplicates have been removed. Actually, there's one more thing we would like to fix. We would like to add the string all to the expression. When the user selects all in the combo box, books of all genres will be visible. The last touch is to work on the formatting. Select the cells and set the size to small. To loosen things up a bit, let's also set the pattern of the cells to 2dp. Let's run the simulation to check our combo box. At this stage, we can see all the values of the combo box, but nothing works yet. Importantly, whenever you select a genre in the combo box, the selection becomes immediately visible in the persistent tree in the simulator. This way, we can make sure everything works as expected. To be able to switch between the genres, we need to define which data must be visible. Let's first set the visibility property for the author's row. Make sure the author's row is selected, then navigate to the table row group section and set the visibility property as follows. The expression reads as follows. If the user selects all in the combo box, then books of all genres will be visible. If the user selects something other than all, the expression will iterate over all the authors, and if at least one book of an author belongs to the selected genre, the author's details and all their books will be displayed. As you can see, MobileTogether has identified the context node. The XPath we are using here must be relative, because we must verify only the books of a particular author for whom we are calculating visibility. The usage of the full XPath would always return true and include all the books. Let's run the simulation to see how the visibility property works. Switch to hover and scroll to the bottom of the page. You will notice that all Stephen King's books are listed here. The only trouble is, the last book belongs to the fantasy genre. In order to fix this, we also need to set the visibility property on the books. Make sure the books row is selected, then navigate to the table row group properties and set the visibility property as follows. This way, we make sure that only the relevant books will be listed. You can see that the expression is a bit different this time. This is because the context node changed when we selected the books row. Run the simulation again to see the end result. Check out our next tutorial in which we will show you how to edit data and save it back to the database. You can try these features for yourself. Simply download the free MobileTogether Designer from the Eldova website.